No.
Hi there, I'm Andy Howell. I'm a professor of physics at the University of California, Santa Barbara, and an astronomer at Las Cumbres Observatory. That's where we're building telescopes like the ones behind me to study planets around other stars. Planets are huge things, but that same science that applies to big things in space also applies to small things like our angry birds. Did you know that planets move around according to the same laws of physics that the angry birds do? We're gonna do some experiments to learn about those laws today.
Use the trampolines! Who wants a birdie back?
I'd be pretty angry if some greedy pig stole my eggs and put them in a castle. You're gonna attack a castle. There's only one way to do it in style. You need a catapult.
Remember, the goal is the castle. Get to the castle.
But those birds are pretty clever. Instead of building a big, heavy contraption to shoot rocks, they use a slingshot to shoot themselves into the castle. It's not a catapult, it's a birdapult.
Let me at him!
Launch!
This contraption is really famous. If you've played the game Angry Birds, you know the idea. You pull back on the slingshot and release it to send your birds flying into the air. It's important that the angle of the slingshot is accurate so you can send your birds to the right trajectory to hit their target. One of the reasons the birds were so successful with their slingshot is because they were using physics. There are a few simple rules that tell you how things fly around in space. But humans were around for tens of thousands of years before we figured them out. Can you believe that? It's because first, we had to invent science.
Science.
The rules governing motion were first figured out by Sir Isaac Newton more than 300 years ago, back in the 1600s. He figured out what we call Newton's three laws of motion. Today, we're gonna do some really fun experiments to see how they work. Newton's first law is that objects in motion tend to stay in motion, but objects at rest tend to stay at rest. In other words, once you get going, it's really hard to slow down. You have to hit something to stop. Remember how those birds kept running into stuff after they got going really fast? The flip side of that is that it takes a lot of pushing to get something moving in the first place. To demonstrate that, I'm gonna pull this tablecloth out from under all this stuff. Did you see that? That was so cool. Let's see that again in slow motion. That's so cool. Why did the glass and stuff just stay there? It's because they have what's called inertia. That's just a fancy way of saying that objects at rest tend to stay at rest, just like Newton's first law says. But once you get an object moving, it'll just stay moving unless you stop it. On Earth, friction from the air stops a ball you'd throw from just going forever. But in space, there's no air. So if I threw a ball hard enough to get it into space, which I could totally do, it'll just keep going forever. Newton's second law says that heavier objects take more force to accelerate. That's just a fancy way of saying that it's harder to push heavy things to make them move fast. Remember when the birds wanted to shoot far? It was really heavy, so they had to pull back their slingshot really far to shoot them with a lot of force. Another way to say that is that if you give two objects the same push, the lighter one will go faster. To demonstrate that, I have two balls here. One is really heavy, but the other one is really light. Now I'm gonna kick each one of them with the same amount of force. Whoa, see, that one went really fast. They got the same push, but the light ball went really far, while the heavy one didn't move much. I guess that's why those little hatchlings can go really far. Newton's third law is my favorite. It says for every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction. Like when a bird hits something and they get sent flying in a different direction, the action is them hitting something and the reaction is that their flight gets changed.
Judge Howell!
To show this, I'm gonna get in my rocket car. It's a wagon, and on top, we have a fire extinguisher, and it shoots carbon dioxide out the bottom. When I pull the handle, it'll open the fire extinguisher. Let's see what happens. Rocket time!
My favorite way to travel.
This is how I get to work every morning. I shoot gas out the back and it makes me shoot forward. It must take a lot of gas to move somebody so big so fast.
Take that, porkers!
Incoming!
This is how rockets work. They shoot gas out the back and then makes you fly into space.
Faster!
The birds do things by trial and error. That's just like doing experiments. That's what scientists do when they want to figure something out. When we do it enough times, we can use math to predict what's going to happen. That lets us do things like build airplanes and go to the moon. If you want to be a rocket scientist, you've already got a great head start. You already know the basics. Me, I'm just a rocket wagon scientist. Physics is awesome, especially when delivered by slingshot. Back to the telescope from me. See you in space, future scientists.